Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can merge two sorted arrays. So I will be telling you how you can write the algorithm for merge two sorted array into C language, right? So first of all, let me implement two arrays. So this is first array. This is second array. So first array is having four elements, 1, 2, 3, 4. Second array is having four elements, 2, 4, 6, 8. And they will be merged to third array. So its size will be 8. Right? So this way, we need to merge these two sorted arrays to third array so that third array will be available automatically into sorted array. So for this, I am going to write a function. So name of function is merge. It will be receiving a1, a2, and a3 array as input, and int n1 and n2. So n1 is the size of first array and n2 is the size of second array. Now inside this, I'm going to declare three variables I, j, and k. So I, j, k variables will be used for pointing the indexes. So I will be for a1, j will be for a2, and k will be for a3. Right? So here I am applying a loop. So where I is initialized with 0, j with 0, and k with 0. So all three variables are initialized with 0. Now here I am going to apply a condition. If I less than n1 and j less than n2, if both the conditions are true, then only this loop will repeat and it will be incrementing value of k. Now inside this loop, I will compare a1 of I with a2 of j. So if a1 of I value is less than a2 of j, it means we can assign this number because it is smaller. So we can assign this number into A3. So here I am writing A3 of K equals to A1 of I. And here I am incrementing I with 1. Because K is incremented here as a common increment and I is incremented here. So either we need to increment I or we need to increment J based on this condition. And if this condition is false, then A3 of K will be having A2 of J value. And here we need to increase J. So this way, this loop will be implemented that will be copying the smaller element into A3. So let's say indexes are 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, and 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right? So IJK. Initially they are 0. Now check this condition. So m1 and n2. So here n1 is 4, n2 is also 4 because both are having 4 elements. So here we can see I am using less than. So I is 0, which is less than n1, and j is less than n2, both are 2. And in between they have n condition. If both are true, then this loop will repeat. So right now both are true. A1 of I is 1. A2 of J is 2. So this condition is true. So A1 of I, it means 1 will be assigned to A3 of K position. And I will be incremented. So I is now 1. This else part will not execute. Then K will be incremented. So K is also 1. Now check these two conditions. So I is 1, 1 is less than 4, it is true, and j is 0, which is also less than 4, so it is true. Now we need to compare this. So a1 of i is this, and a2 of j is still on this position. So compare both. So 2 is less than 2, false. So we will come here. So from a2, j position value will be copied to a3 of k position. So from here 2 will be copied, j will be incremented, so j is now 1, and k will be incremented, so k is 2. So this way you saw one element from A1 is copied and one element from A2 is copied, right? Then again check these conditions. So both are true, both are 1, 1, so both are less than 4. Now check this. A1 of 1 is 2, A2 of j is 4. So both arrays 1, 1 and x are having 2 and 4 as a value. So this time this condition is true. So A1 value will be copied to A3. So 2 will be copied here, I will be incremented. Then this is false, so K will be incremented, so K is now. So this way, this is copied, it is already copied. So I is 2, so both the conditions are true. So A1 of I, so A1 of I is this, A2 of J, so J is still on 1, so 1 index is 4. So again it is true, so A1 of I position will go to A3 of K. So here 3 will be copied. So it is also copied. Then I will be incremented, so I is 3. Then K will be incremented, so K is now 4. Now 3 position is having 4 and this J is on 1 position, so it is having 4. So again check this, so it is false. So this time A2 of J will be copied to A3. So it will be copied here. J is 2 and K is now 5. Again check these conditions, so these are still true. A1 of I is having 4, A2 of J is having 2, because I is 3 and J is 2, so 3 index is 4 and 2 index is 6. So again check this condition, it is true. So from A1 array I position value will be copied here, so it will be copied here and I will be incremented to 4 and K will be incremented to 6. So this time if we check this condition, so I is 4, which is not less than 4 because N1 is also 4. So this loop will be terminated. So you can see A1 all elements are copied, but A2's 2 elements are remaining because they are greater as compared to A1. And this can happen also with if A1 is having greater elements as compared to A2, so some elements will remain into A1. So now we need to implement 2 loops so that we can copy remaining elements of A1 or A2 into A3, right? So now I am applying while I less than N1. So if I is less than N1 still, so we can write A3 of K equals to A1 of I and I plus plus and K plus plus. So if A1 array is having some remaining elements, so they will be copied to A3 as it is based on this condition. And right now A2 is having remaining elements, so while J is less than N2, so A3 of K will be having A2 of J, then K plus plus and J plus plus, and then you can complete this. So this way your third array is having either remaining elements of A1 or remaining elements of A2. So in this case remaining of A2 will be copied as it is, and you can see this A3 is now in sorted form. So this way A3 is having all the elements of A1 and A2 merged in sorted form. So whenever you will be calling this merge function, by mistake I incorrect spelling. So if you are calling this merge function into a main function, so you will be passing 3 arrays and third array is having the output, and this will be updated automatically. So you can print A3 in this method, or you can print A3 in main function. So in main function also A3 will be printing this result, that is correct one, right? So this way I hope you understood how we can merge 2 sorted arrays into third array. So if you want to see or if you want to learn like how we can write its algorithm, so you can go to description of this video. You will find link of the playlist where all the algorithms are available related to different topics. Also you can if you go to end of this video, you will find links of playlist and videos, so follow them. And I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. Thank you for watching this.